worried that the presidential election is going to screw up the housing market. Well, that's what I'm talking about today, and I'm getting started right now. My name is Eli Magas, and I'm a real estate advisor here in Charlotte, North Carolina, and its surrounding areas, specializing in luxury homes and new home construction. But more importantly, I'm your realtor with heart. I'm not trying to sell you a house. I'm here to help you find a home and a lifestyle that you and your family are going to love. My gift is people. My profession is helping you find a home. Put the two together, and we can create the next best part of your life. It is so important to find somebody who you like and somebody who you trust. If you think that you and I are a good fit, I would love to hear from you and I would love to help. My contact information is down below. I put out videos every single week about the best of Charlotte and the best about real estate. And I don't want you to miss any of those videos. So go down, hit the red button, subscribe, hit the bell, and you'll be notified when my new videos are out every single week. And stay tuned to the very end of this video where I'm going to give you a free online guide that's going to tell you everything about Charlotte, its housing, its neighborhoods, its schools, but you got to stay tuned to the very end. So you're worried about what's going to happen with this presidential election, which is going to take place today. Well, I came across an article and I think it would be cool for me just to kind of show it to you and kind of go through it with you at the same time. So here we go. Four reasons why the election won't dampen the housing market. This is coming from Keeping Current Matters, which is a publication sent out all over the country. So tomorrow, Americans will decide our president for the next 4 years. That decision will have a major impact on many aspects of life in this country, but the residential real estate market will not be one of them. Analysts will try to measure the impact feasible changes in regulations might have on our housing, the effect of possible first-time home buyer programs, and any number of other solutions based on who wins. The housing market, however, will remain strong for four reasons. This is what they say. Number one, demand is strong among millennials. The nation's largest generation began entering the housing market last year as they reached the age to marry and have children, two key drivers of home ownership. As the Wall Street Journal recently reported, millennials, long viewed as perennial home renters who were reluctant or unable to buy, are now emerging as a driving force in the U.S. housing market's recent recovery. Number two, mortgage rates are historically low. All-time low interest rates are also driving demand across all generations. And I'm seeing that here in Charlotte. Strong demand created by this rate drop has countered other economic disruptions. Examples are obviously the coronavirus pandemic, the recession, and our record unemployment. In addition, Freddie Mac, which is a government agency, just forecasted mortgage rates to remain low through next year. One of the main drivers of the strong housing recovery is historically low mortgage interest rates. Given weakness in the broader economy, the Federal Reserve signaled that its policy rate will remain low until inflation picks up or there's no signs of inflation. They are forecasting mortgage rates to remain flat over the next year. From the third quarter of 2020, where we are now, through the end of 2021, Freddie Mac is forecasting mortgage rates to remain unchanged at 3%. I have clients that are getting them in the mid 2% for mortgage rates. So mortgage rates are driving a lot of this. As we see here in Charlotte and everywhere else in the country, there are bidding wars. Prices continue to appreciate. The continued lack of supply of existing homes and new homes, for that matter, are for sale, are coupled with surge in buyer demand, has experts forecasting strong price appreciation over the next 12 months. Here in Charlotte, even the new home market, we cannot find lots to build on. It is just booming. The number four reason why the presidential election will not have an effect on the housing market is because history says so. Though it's true that the market slows slightly in November when it's a presidential election year, the pace returns quickly. Here's an explanation as to why from the Home Building Industry Report. This may indicate that potential home buyers may become more cautious in the face of a national election and its uncertainty. This caution is temporary and ultimately results in deferred sales as the economy, jobs, interest rates, and consumer confidence all have far more meaningful roles in the home purchase decision rather than the presidential election result in the months that follow. So they're saying that the presidential election will basically slow things down a little bit in November, then things will pick back up. In addition, the chief economist for Myers Research, whoever they may be, says history suggests that the slowdown is largely concentrated in the month of November. In fact, the year after the presidential election is the best of the four-year cycle. This suggests that demand for new housing is not lost because of election uncertainty. Rather, it gets pushed out to the following year as long as the economy stays on track, which is a big, we don't know what's going to happen with the coronavirus, right? So we don't know how the economy is going to do, but based on history, the presidential election doesn't really affect the housing market. So the bottom line is, there's no doubt that this is one of the most contentious presidential elections in our nation's history. The outcome will have a major impact on many sectors of the economy. However, as Matthew Speakman, an economist at Zillow, explained last week, while the path of the overall economy is likely to be most directly dictated by coronavirus-related and political developments in the coming months, recent trends suggest that the housing market, which has basically withstood every pandemic-related challenge to this point, will continue its strong momentum in the months to come. So bottom line is the presidential election doesn't seem to affect the housing market. It's all going to depend on what's going to go on with the coronavirus, whether we get a stimulus package, and we see how the economy recovers. It is so important to find somebody who you like and somebody who you trust. If you think that you and I are a good fit and you're looking for a luxury home or a new home construction in the Charlotte metropolitan area, I would love to help. My contact information is down below. And don't forget, I put out new videos every single week talking about the best of Charlotte and the best about the economy. So I don't want you to miss those. Go down to the red button below. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell. You'll be notified when my new videos are out every single week. And for that free guide that I talked about all the different neighborhoods, go down to the link below in the description. There's a link there. Free guide for communities, schools, so on and so forth. Click on that link. It's invaluable information and get that for free. In a couple of minutes, a couple more of my other videos are going to be popping up. Check those out. But most importantly, thank you so much for watching. I welcome you to this wonderful neighborhood of Charlotte. Let's see who's going to be our next president. Maybe it's going to be the same one. Maybe it's going to be a different one. We don't know. And until we see each other again next time.